death must answer me these questions three. Ere the other side he see.
Ask me the questions, Bridgekeeper. I am not afraid.
What is your name?
My name is Sir Lancelot of Camelot.
What is your quest?
To seek a game of magic.
What is your favorite format?
Popper.
Right, off you go.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much.
Hey everybody, it's Deluxikoff. It's Friday. We're playing Slivers. Please let me know in the chat. We had a little bit of technical difficulty last week. Got new PC and all. So everything sounding and looking okay, guys. Just let me know in the chat before I get moving too far forward here. We've got four of these, three of these, two Aurum's Cure. That's kind of the secret tech of this deck. I used to run Armadillo Cloak here. Feel free to use this spot, anything you want. I really like this because of the power of mutagenic growth in Slivers. Usually the Lord comes out, and if they can deal with it, it's a tough game. If they can't, you win. And that's why I run all four mutagenic growths and two Vines of Vastwood. And these kind of take the place as a free spell as long as you got a planes out there. Anyway, we got the Sidewinder Slivers, great flanking ability, the Plated Silver. So the big difference, four mutagenic growths, we have two communes, two vines, four of the poison slivers, four muscle slivers, four of the same things here, three spinnerets. Now, Mythonical and I went over this list ad nauseum with regards to the mana, and you'll notice there's a bit of a discrepancy in the green, but four of them are free spells. Excuse me. Had a lot of carbonation this morning. Woo! Everything's sounding good, guys? Let me know. Don't want to get too far in before I know I can. Everything's looking and sounding good. So that's mana for this is two Ash Barrens, four Sands. We've got, what is it, six Forests. I believe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 Plains and one Sanctuary. Good times. Thank you for that. SRS Business 42. Thank you for chiming in and letting me know. Good times. So anyway, we got two Hollows in the sideboard. I found, believe it or not, Burn is a tough matchup with this. So two Hollows, one Circle of Protection Red, two Standard Bears, three Strands, two Pulse of Marasa, two Quick Slivers. I really like this because of just the control matchups end of turn. I found it a lot better in my playstyle anyway than Scattershot Archers. And I hate to say it or play it, but we needed it. Three Gleeful Sabotage. So without further ado, we're going to jump in and hopefully do a lot better than we've been doing. Because while this isn't a Tier 1 deck, it's been playing like it with me. I've had 5 4-1s and 1 5-0 with it. So, of course, you know, I'm sure today's the day I'm going to crash burn or whatever. But we'll see. And up to no go. Oh, and this is, I was just going to say in the challenge, the one person I didn't want to face was Green Prinny with Tribe, and I lost real bad to it because this deck has no game against Green Prinny. And I hope he wasn't waiting in the weeds to beat me with Tribe, knowing that I go online at 12, but maybe he was. We shall see. Yes, I'm running Sabotage, I know. But if we're going to lose to anybody, it should be a good friend. Green Prinny. All right. Little keep, scary keep here. I mean, I probably might have wanted to mull that, but we'll see. Just that we've got a one drop. We are running a tad bit more land than normal. As long as we get one more, we'll be fine. And off to the races. Mutagenic here, really, really key matchup. Uh-oh, looks like he's on Gond. This could be a issue too. The main problem with Slivers is no kidding. The big issue with this deck is just its lack of removal. And I just found that kind of going for the throat is usually the best play there. So we'll see. We're not a fan of this, but we do have poison damage, so life isn't that big of a deal as long as we can keep it alive. But we're going to need what we really want here is a plane. And we'll go from there. I probably shouldn't have kept that hand. I'll be honest with you. As things starting, I thought it was up against Tribe. And, that's no excuse. This hand's not that great against Tribe either, so that's not going to do too much. I mean, it kills our mutagenic. Our Aurum's Cure can still be pointed at our face. We'll go from that. All right. Flanking still works no matter what. Come on, land. There we go. All righty. Well, let's see. since we have no ability to protect our dude, well, I guess we do, but it would have to be, let's see. Wow, look at this. How cool is this? Orm's Cure. Usually I use it on my own self, but it says target creature you control. So we can play a lord here. I'll play the one of artwork I don't like the most to see if we can get through here. Let him gain his little life there, and we'll go for here. No amount of blocking saves the flankers. R&D function. All right. Thanks for joining us, buddy. Glad everything's looking and sounding good. Yeah, this has about 0.7 more lands than it should, but we're really gearing towards efficiency and continuity and however else you want to say it. So like, if he does Lightning Bolt this, I mean, A Journey to Nowhere, we're dead meat, but if he does Lightning Bolt this, not that that deck has many of those, but we're going to be able to survive nicely just because Orm's Cure is my little two-drop spot. I'm not in love with the card, but I definitely am liking it. I think we ought to turn on our poison pretty soon. Let me see. Let me get the Lords activated here. The poison damage is going to pay dividends the more slivers we have out, and then all of a sudden it's like two swings and it doesn't matter how much life he's got. So we'll go from there. Now remember, that's another reason we kind of lean towards a little higher land count. I did play Armadillo Cloak for a while, love it, but against decks where I wanted it to really go through, they usually had the damage and then it was just kind of over at that point. So hopefully, oh good, our little fight's back up and running. Yeah, it's such a finicky world out there with all this technology. And last week, I got this new PC, all this stuff going. I was noticing all these programs that just all this nefarious sort of downloaded software that keeps showing up. And I'm like, gosh darn it, what is the deal here with, well, you know, I'm just going to keep dropping lords. There's a good name for a band. I was noticing all this little nefarious software. I had that eye tracking thing keep showing up. And I think after a while, it just, even though this is a brand new computer or laptop, it just really slowed everything down and got to the kind of a molasses point. So we're out of burn range. Got to worry about some journeys here, but Lord drop. Oh, here comes the love. Well, you got to what? Choose. Still take four. Got a nice little even color combo going here. I really want to see a forest so I can drop the Sentinel with the Virulent and go from there. There's part of the combo. Dead meat if he's got the rest of it, because we don't really have an answer for that. Green Prinny seems to have a knack for playing decks that Slivers is bad against. Okay, well, hey, there's part of the there's part of that, except that I have to target it on the Standard Bear. So I'm going to ignore that. And, he's got that. We'll drop the poison action here. Hope for the best. Hopefully he doesn't have it, but he draws pretty well usually. So, am I late or are you early, Sitcheraz? Oh, come on. Look at the clock, baby. You don't have to ask that. That's what it's all about. What's he got? Another prismatic strands hanging on there? Okay. What's really cool when you play Slivers, or if you haven't, it's a deck a lot of newbies play. I'm really enjoying it. Just kind of a nice relaxing deck to play. Not too much to think about. There are some little combat issues and stuff, but one of the neat things is dropping another Virulent Sliver down, because then you really get the does he got it? He's got it. I don't think we have a way through this. We have flanking though, so he can't really block anything, but he can block forever, which sucks. That darn Standard Bear really kind of meant the difference there. Yeah, I don't know if we have much of a game here, guys. Might be able to beat him on. Don't want this to go to time. And one of the other reasons I don't like, I've always bitched about, Gleeful Sabotage, is how it just doesn't, at instant speed. See, if I had the like one green instant disenchant, it's over. He gets one creature out of it. Well, he's got the bodyguard, but that only targets the creature, not the enchantment. So I like that one that costs one green at three or less. I think that's usually the best one, or even a natural state, because it can nail Pestilence, even though it grants them four life. Usually when all your guys are 4/4s, you're pretty set to go, but we'll see here. Yeah, I'll probably scoop after this. Run into my own deck. Darn it. I hate playing decks I design. Gond Deluxe. Yowza. Yeah, natural state. That's the one. Yeah, yeah, yeah. All right. Yeah, is there a... I forgot. I think I asked this a while back. I think there's a savings time in other countries, right? Yeah. This Aurum's Cure, though, it's neat how it can be pointed at you. And because it's a tournament, I'm going to let him use a little bit of his clock. So if you control a plains, you may tap an untapped creature you control rather than pay its mana cost. Prevent the next four that would be dealt to target creature or player this turn. Oh, I was wrong. That's you have to tap an untapped creature I control, of course, so that this isn't that great with the standard bear out there. So, yeah, yeah, yeah. Not a way to get through this. I'm going to concede just to keep the feed going here. We'll let him take that down. Now, we've got Gleeful, which isn't going to really do much. Standard Bearer will do some stuff, so we'll bring in Standard Bearer. I'm not sure of the list there. Vines is good if we've got it. And there's going to be some flyers, so Spinneret's going to be good. Standard Bearer, yeah. Maybe I'll lose two cures. So far, so good. Now, if he's got it, Prismatic Strands is only going to buy time, so I'm not sure if that's really a good call here. I'd rather have the... see how low our curve is. It just stops at two. Same with Gleeful. If he has it, what am I really targeting, right? He's going to make 1,000 tokens, so a little bit of a note to myself. I mean, I knew going in that it would be kind of neat, but I might want to mix up the Gleeful and Natural State. I'm thinking, or maybe just all three natural states. I'm not sure. It is good against Affinity, but, you know, so is Prismatic Strands. So, seeing a little bit of a blip. I haven't faced this yet. I've been running into nothing but, like, Stompy, Tron, which I'm surprised. I thought I was going to scoop to Tron every single time, and it's been pretty good. So, we've got Quick Sliver. That's not going to do anything. So, yeah, we're kind of, don't have much here. I don't know if you guys understand that logic. I mean, if I'm playing Prismatic Strands against him, he's already got the game, at least a swing later. So we're just going to go from this, and hopefully our Standard Bears come out, or he doesn't have his combo right out of the gate. So, darn Twitch. I mean, MTG. Hey, get over here, baby. There we go. Yeah, Green Printing's had my number lately. Alrighty. Well, we've got some Lords and Hordes. We'll keep this. Not the greatest, not the worst. Hopefully we rock right into a... I'm going to just get the guys out first. Get out of any sort of... Maybe he's got Grape Shot, Electricity. We're already out of range of that. So that's the theory anyway. Yeah, that's what I've been seeing, Mike, man. And I was really hoping he was on Boros because this just stomps Boros. It's usually there's that cadence of that turn where I know I'm fond of saying that, but you know, they have a Firebolt in their opening hand. You drop a Lord, Mutagenic, and the game's over. It's really like that. And then when I was testing this, it was just like, man, I love Vines, but I always, always wanted to see Mutagenic. So that made for it pretty quick. And flanking, whenever I've played against Slivers, it's usually when you're not prepared to face it or you're like, who the hell plays Slivers? That's when this Sidewinder just shows up and just ruins your world. There are so many decks that just takes out and ruins the plans for and such. It's brutal. All right, we will yield to that. Sorry, I might have tried to make him clock out, but I'm full tourney mode here. Don't want to bore the feed here. So I should say I'm not full tourney mode. Hey, any UFC fans out there, man, I am so excited. It's very rare that I full out buy a UFC fight, but I'm gonna do it this time. It's crazy good. Be nice if we had our vines there, but hey, we'll see here. Okay, we'll drop this. Okay, and play slow with this. A lot of times I'll drop the wrong colored Lord, and I'm like, oh, shoot, I shut myself out of that mana. And this really favors kind of beginner pacing, too. And what I mean by that is I've always had a bad habit of casting stuff first, then attacking. But in Slivers, that kind of rewards you as it does in Goblins. Don't be too shy with that. We are not putting on enough pressure since he's dropped that Lord. and a little worried that he's sitting on something. I mean, I'd love to get the standard bearer out there. That'll make me feel a little bit better. Or poison. That would be kind of nice, but hopefully he's a little stuck on mana. Kapow! Says Little Fight. Be sweet if we could hit Gon with a well-timed out-of-nowhere mana tithe. Yeah, no joke. Especially with the mana issues he's running into here, it looks like, anyway. Good grief. Let's get moving here. Yeah, I think I'm going to keep that mutagenic for just surprise value, or if he has an answer to my standard bear, if we ever draw the damn thing, maybe I need one more of those. All right. I'm a little worried here because while that, yes, he is screwed, that also means he's got just gems in his hand, all six cards, so hopefully we'll keep him off of prismatic math here. A lot of times mutagenic's that extra little kill shot too, where people just don't see it coming, and you know, they don't decide to block, and you're like, bink, get you right in there too. So I'm gonna probably have to take quite a few bathroom breaks today. I've just drank way too much caffeine this morning, and yeah, not to get too graphic, but hey, that's what it's all about. Actually, that's not what it's all about. Okay, so we've got a bit of an answer here. And depending on his blocking situation here, we might, could we have the game here? Let's see, this is a 5, 9, 11, nope. Next turn maybe, if he doesn't want to block, but we'll keep playing it slow. Good news, if Journey shows up or anything else, we've got a little bit of an answer. What's this? A bodyguard, okay, 4 more life. Hey, oh boy, I regret making this thing every time I face it. Boy, Green Prinny and both Mythonical, they seem to have taken my list, and they played a lot better than I did. I had a few 5-0s with it. I even played one without Gond in it. I just had Skyfishers and Journeys swapped in and out. We might have it here, unless he's got some fog technology. Of course, he could have a Vines himself. That would ruin our plan or of surprise. Maybe not. I'll go from here. Come on in. Come on, bodyguard, what you got? So that's 3, 4, 5. There's 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Okay. Which one don't I care about the most? We'll go here. Here. And here, just because he can't target it anyway. And hope we win. Do we? We do. All right, so that's a loss and a win. Here's the tiebreaker. Got a little lucky with him getting mana screwed there. Be nice if our stuff showed up, though. Yeah, Gleeful. Yeah, just... That's a flaw. That's a flaw. The list I should be running is probably 3 of the natures. And, you know, it's not going to come up that often. But look, you know, 5 rounds is a lot. You're going to run into some stuff. So, yeah, and I can't say enough about Hollow against Affinity and against Searing Blaze. It's just like, gain 6, stop that, keep moving. Go from there. Hey, let's get a little superstitious here. Or not. I guess Magic's... I was going to move some stuff around just for the hell of it. But, yeah, we like this hand. Nice, just basic hand here. Got an answer. Got aggression. I like this. Keep. And we'll... SRS Business 42 is in the house. First time I think you've chimed in, so thank you, thank you. Very cool to see you. I'm going to lead off with the Virulent Sliver here, just because he is on a life deck. Might be kind of cool to go for broke here. All right, what's he grabbing? What's he grabbing? Forest in the house. Boy, I was so blown away. I know Little Fight said that everything looked and sounded good last week, but God, when I watched the replay for quality control, I was just blown away by how clean this screen is. I was just tripping out. What I've found playing Slivers 2, might be obvious to some of you, it wasn't to me. I used to like to drop Lords right away, but Lords are good, but if you've got one of your 2-2 naturals, you drop that first, and then you do 3 instead of 2 that next turn, and it makes for a little bit better outing. And normally, against most matchups, you're going to want to favor your Sinew Sliver over the others because of Prismatic Strands and such. That's about it. Whoop. And hopefully we just draw another Forest because I want to be able to hold back Vines. But good thing about midnight gone presence, you can usually see it coming quite a ways away. First time I'm catching the whole cast, got part of that gruel control effort. Dot, dot, dot. Yeah, good way to say it. But hey, I prefaced about the last 2 months of plays with what we expected to do, mostly like a 1-4 or 2-3 outing. This one, I expect to go at least 3-2. Reason I say that is just he's really hurting on math. Maybe cut one of the lands. I'm not sure. I've had six tournaments with this. I've had 1-5-0, and every other one was a 4-1. In almost every one of those 4-1s, I lost the very first round. And I haven't really been keeping that good of stats. I apologize. I just haven't. I don't know what the scoop is. I just haven't. But once more creatures come out or I get another source, I'm going to drop here. But right now, this is just a Lord game and see if we can slow them down. Now, Gleeful would feel really good, right? Get back our poison and our Lords and all this stuff. But yeah, who knows? About time I give. Hopefully, I'm not going to say anything. I've been cursing myself with all this stuff. Ruzmov, good to see you. Thanks for chiming in. Woohoo. Vigilance. Yeah, and you know what? If you don't like Orym's Cure, feel free to just add one more of these and one more of the Flying Dude, because they're pretty awesome cards in and of themselves. And I've thought about doing that depending on the metagame. So, you know, what you going to do? Do I mix it up here? Or do I go white? Because if he's packing Prismatic Strands, I'm going to favor white. Because if he double blocks, it's not going to do that much. These are tiny little small percentages here and there. But just gets into good times. At this stage, he's probably getting to that point where he's going to double block, sack the bodyguard to keep the warden alive sort of thing. Or not. That's what I would have done. So he would have prevented a bit more damage there. But this gets pretty hopeless here. Shrazman, Simi. Hey, all right. So we win that one. I would think we're not favored there if you draw decently, but hey, I'm going to... It's Green Printing and I go back and forth, but lately he's kind of had my number. I think he's got me two in a row, so it's nice to get a little bit of revenge, but yowza, says Mike Mann. Yeah, so, Orym's Cure, if you can bring that up in the MTG bot. This isn't... I'm not sold on it, but I really do like seeing it because it's like mutagenic... 5 and 6 against the decks that you're bad against, which, you know, Lightning Bolt in that early round, that sort of thing. So Astor 665, thank you for chiming in. And hey, if you're out there hiding in the weeds and waiting in the weeds, whatever that magic card is, man, don't be shy. I don't even know if you're there till like hours later, and then it's no big deal. So if you want a shout out or whatever, just chime in, tell us you're out there and lurking and being a stalker, and we all love you, as long as you like Popper. Hey, what'd you guys think? Did anybody catch that Monty Python Bridge of Death? I think I got the last two voices pretty close. That first one, it was hard to do the accent, but... Yeah, and I have a new favorite soda. It's Diet Dr. Pepper. I've never been much of a Dr. Pepper fan, but gosh, for some reason, man, Dr. Pepper tastes... The diet one tastes so good. So that's, if you're curious... What my libation of choice is today, it's that. Yeah, this is kind of a hand. I mean, I'm going to keep it. We don't have a plane, so that's dead. All right. We're on the draw. We'll keep. We will keep. And I've lost one game to Stompy, but I've won about six. So hopefully we run into that. Let's see here. Not the best against Tron. We have to run them over. And Methonical and I went over these lists for a while here. And one thing we noticed was, you know, at first my list had a lot of relics. It seemed kind of cool. And then you're like, well, you know, if you're casting relics and relying on them against Tron, you're kind of playing Slivers wrong. And it was kind of nerve-wracking for me to do it. Yeah, he's already got Tron. This is ridiculous. It was already a little nerve-wracking for me to do it, but I was like, you know what, you're right. And ever since I did that, I was just kind of winning with Tron. So there's that. We can only play one thing. I know I have just said that I want to keep my Sliver count, but I kind of want to bait some removal here. So I think I'm gonna lead. Now, let's see. We have a plethora of green, so I'm going to lead with white. That's another thing I've learned early on, depending if you do get mana screwed later. We've got Vine's backup here. Commune with Nature's great card in this list. Two feels really right. But, yeah, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, here comes the mine, and looks like we're going to have the same round as last round, where we're probably going to lose this first one. I mean, the power level of Tron when it hits that, what is this, turn three? Ridiculous. All we can hope for is too much carbonation. All we can hope for here is he tries to target this with something and we can at least use our vines, but maybe not. Maybe he's after some counter-heavy build, right? All right. Let's drop the Lord. I like to save this one because I like the artwork so much more than this one, so I use this sliver, the predatory sliver, as a sacrificial lamb a lot of times. I know, pretty silly thing to concern yourself with, but hey. And considering that most of these have, what do you call, life-gaining spells and Marasa and such, it might be good to get this poison on board right now. Really want a plane, but it's, you know, the plane's not going to be that good against black-based removal, so that's why I only run two of the chance there. Boggles in the current meta. Yeah, that last week's list, that was so cool. Very cool. I mean, it kind of used the Boros Kitty draw engine, just mega consistency. That was the Boggles list that won last challenge. Forget who the pilot was. Fascinating take, though, on, let's see how counter happy they are. Fascinating take on consistency. In those big tournaments, like I know, I mean, I've only topped eight once, but you get that milestone you've got to hit of just that consistency where you just, you know, it's like, yeah, I can make this a little meaner, or I could make it almost never get screwed or flooded. And I think that hit it nicely. It's pretty hard for, I think he caught himself being, what do you call, what's the word I'm looking for here? Counter happy. Well, I know I'm probably going to walk into it, but I want to drop a Lord here and drop a Lord just because I'm a little afraid of Evan Carr's Justice. Orm's Cure will help a little bit if I had a plane, but we don't, and we're probably going to eat a, what's it going to be? Counterspell. All right. That's not too bad. Poison for two, hit for four. Keep him up against it. I recently played some D-pack in the practice room. I was playing a workshop Tron deck. missed you guys. It's been a whole week. Feels like a month, man. You guys are like my digital family. I love it. Now, it seems sad probably to somebody chiming in like, oh, this poor guy. It's like, no, man, it's cool. I don't like crowds anyway. It's good seeing just digital versions, right? And we got this cool tournament. I don't know if you guys saw YouTube, but somebody emailed us and wanted some love as far as promoting Pauper, and I think it's in Illinois, but I'll be rolling to it as the first commercial. It's our $1,000 store credit tournament. Unreal. So if you've got the time, that's a pretty badass tournament there. So all right, let's go over from here. All right, we'll keep going from here, attack with these. Poison, poison, poison. I doubt that we're going to... It just doesn't... Tron being activated. Well, he's only drawn one, two cards off that, so... Yeah, I mean, we've got lethal poison damage next turn. Able to save a Lord if he Evan Carrs. I don't know if he's going to be able to, but he won't have much counter colors after that, so... All right. What's going in the book? What did I miss? Mudtron? That sounds pretty cool. Yeah, this is probably where we get the... that's another thing. You know, I completely ignored Graveyard Hate. I was just over this when I saw the power plant drop on the first play. But, yeah, it'd be kind of cool. You know, maybe run some fairies out. And it's like, I just kind of diluted the deck. And I'd rather just draw another Lord and attack, and just keep that pressure up. So who knows? Maybe I'll change it up. I think we've got Moon Cheese Babies. Yeah, that's our last break today. So anybody that's wondering what the hell are they talking about with Moon Cheese Babies, stay tuned. You'll see it on our third commercial break. So, alrighty. Gosh darn it. Where's our planes? We run a preponderance of them. Let's see. Well, if he's got Moment's Peace, I attack now and he has moments peace. That's great. He just uses his color and then I can play the sliver. So let's do that. Not that it makes our guys tap. Oh yeah, D-bags. Yeah, that guy, the power level of Tron is just absurd. Here comes the moments peace, moments peace. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Boink. All right. Now we're out of range of a lot of removal. A lot of sweeping stuff. Unless he's running Swirling Sandstorm. But I don't think these lists run that. Don't they run Evancar's Justice by two? Can somebody look this up? I've been brewing with Arcane Spyglass. Ooh, nice. Spyglass looks like a flashlight. Little Fight's got a new Simic brew. I didn't even get a chance, Little Fight, to even look over that. But your description sounded cool. But the way, as bad as I've been running lately with Rogue, I was like, I got to play something at least tier 2 or better. And no offense, maybe yours is, but it can only lick my wounds so much. Even when I propose that we're going to lose, it still stings a little bit when you crash and burn as hard as we've been crashing and burning lately. Uh-oh. Here comes the love. Memnonic Wall. What's he going to grab? I'm going to try to just probably count this dude out. Sorry about this. God darn Tron. All right, let's see what he's going to grab here. Yeah, I agree, Mike, man. It's like, come on, man. I don't want to face this boring Tron at this, you know, live. It's like, I don't mind facing it solo. I just focus, F6, and keep moving, but gets monotonous. All right, so we got to... let's see. Which is more important, flanking or the other? Let's go with... just in case he's got some big-time sweeping power here. And we got reach, too, so this game's going to go long no matter what. Just got to keep aware of that Vines move. Not sure if that's a... Well, he hard cast it. That's a good call, unless he's just got a handful of Moments Peace going on here. But how do you protect the Scargon there, Little Fight? That's great when they get active, but sometimes they can slow up. I'm going to close the, just for screen real estate here. I do want to see kind of what he's doing, so apologies. Try to keep the cards. I think he's got our number with mana. All right. Mystical Teachings in the house. What's he going to go grab? I will announce it. He gets a moment's peace. What a D-bag. Just kidding. What's he going to grab now? Probably some counterspell. Condescend to put the capital D in D-bag. We'll see. Oh, and being inspired by, everybody knows I really like the Joe Rogan podcast, and he had a Sober October. So I was a little late to the party, and I figured I'd do a November play on the words there with being able to try to stay off the... stay off the booze for all of November. So that's my goal. So hopefully I might even look a little thinner on camera in the next few weeks. We'll see. Strange why you would want to counter this. Finite supply. Okay. Rather that than the vines, right? Let's get that moment's peace going. Oh. He's at 7:19. I got to start playing the time game here. Just shut up and focus myself. So if anybody sees me mention November, spelled capital N-O, that's what I'm talking about. Hanging up. All right, what's he grabbing? The Mold Drifter. Well, that's not going to be that big of an issue. We might be able to deck him here. This list, can anybody look it up? Did they run a Rolling Thunder? Because if so, we're probably dead. But if he doesn't, we might just be able to outlast him. Because we've got reach creatures. Is that Mike Mann? Is that does he run Rolling Thunder? Do you know? I know his list is online. I don't want to slow up the show showing it. Gosh, this makes for a boring show. I apologize. I hate running into Demir, Control, and Tron when I'm online with Twitch. Unless I'm, you know, I'm playing Infect and you run them over and laugh at them. But it's just makes for a kind of a slower show. All right, resize those cards. Here we go. Other vines would be nice. Yeah. I'm gonna keep that sliver back just because Orym's cure might come in contact where he might just get us killed. Fat chance, but we'll see. All right, so he's got exiled our he's got, how depressing is that? 2 moments peace in the yard. Yeah, it was a freelance XX. Yes, well, should they run capsize in the horror. So I need an answer though. He doesn't have Rolling Thunder. Okay, good to know. All right, well, it makes sense to just kind of hang out here and make him use his clock. We're up about 2 minutes. Sorry, guys. I mean, if you're going to go wash your car or go get a coffee, this is probably the time to do it, because I think we're going to slowly lose this game one, but hopefully we can get him down to about 12 minutes. Yikes. Maybe not. Of course, that's not that scary, believe it or not. I mean, he's probably got counter magic, prohibit, and such behind it, but he's also got the flicker. You just keep letting him draw his cards. Yeah? Did you forget that we have reach? Oops, it's going to take a little bit longer. Let's rock this. Let's rock this. You can't counter nothing because you're going to get killed if you do. Does this make sense? I've already got that blocker there. See what you got. Guess that moment's peace, baby. Yep, there it is. All right, got two of them down. Yeah, the UFC fight this weekend, just insane. I can't get over how amazing that card is. Just blown away. Sliver's getting real beefy. Vines to flicker, says Ruzmov. Yeah, that's kind of the idea here. I'm sure we're going to walk into a counter, but hopefully it'll take up about 10 minutes of his time. Flanking's not doing us much here. Although, it does stop his walls from hitting us. I will lose this and this. Worried about the cap size on my conclave, but we'll see when it happens. And let's go like I'll drop like this. Boop. At least kill the guy, right? Of course, here comes the flicker probably, but at least we'll be able to respond. Moment's peace. Nice. There's the third one. Make him use it again, I guess. 16 minutes down. Use it while we can here. Yeah, I wish I could look at it. If propaganda of the future have like some helpers out and they bring up a little spreadsheet and a little signal to the ear. The percentage of trying Rolling Thunder next turn, 0.0287%. Consensus, pass the turn. F6. Yeah. Boy, feels like I'm sitting on a few islands, if you know what I mean. I have got to get that bathroom break here pretty soon. I'm drinking way too many liquids. I should be on islands. Here goes another shot. All right, mister. I'd just rather run Ash Barrens for the surprise value end of turn. But that's just me. Well, knowing that we've got that, I'll drop this. Boy, where's our land? I mean, I'm not complaining. I'd rather draw stuff than not draw stuff, but he's already got his moments. I just want him to have to use it. What's neat about that Virulent Sliver is that they can get ahead on life, and it still doesn't matter. Don't really have an answer here, but what's nice when you don't have vines and they just start going off and wasting time is that, capsize time? Let's see, Mystical Teachings. Is that you're able to just F6 and buy some time here. Condescend. All right. In comes that. I think he's regretting. Sacrifice too. Permanent, son of a bitch. All right, I'll do this and this. And we'll block here and here. Well, if he has capsize, I want to be able to kill it. So let's do that. Like I said, we're going to lose this one, but he's getting back moments peace. Just whittling our permanence down to where we've got nothing. Pieces in the yard. He's already used up two. Down comes Denrovia. Probably going to bounce our land. We'll pitch this. That's fine. It's looking grim. But the bathroom is calling, so I just got to keep trying to wear out his clock. I don't have to go that bad. I can keep waiting here and watch him play jump rope with himself. 14 minutes. Go pee, man. We got this. No, every little second counts. I've lost a Tron with like a few seconds on, and I'm like, no, if I just had it, I would have had it. Good thing is we got Vigilance, so I'm sure that'll be his next target for that Denrovia. How cool is that? It's like normally you don't attack into this, but it's like we do. So he's got one left. Nope, I'm wrong. He keeps piling that one in and flashing it back, so we're just here to waste time. Slivers we will lose. All right. We'll say this and this. We'll block. Keep using that time. I can't believe I only got him by 3 minutes. That'd be way more than that. Ooh, boy. I am going to swim out of this chair. This keeps up. He might have Marasa and just let me take it and then just be like, boom. Or not. I mean, he's used 10 minutes already. If we have a decent game two, we might get him down to about 8 for the last game. But we don't have any issues. Remember, I said going into this, Tron's not a good matchup. I've been lucky lately. I've been running over it and getting good Lord draws. Lord, for those of you new to Slivers, it just means, this will be kind of cool. I'll play this. If he bounces it, I'll tap it and cycle it and go get something. Should I attack here? 6-4, 4-4. Blocks that, kills that. For time's sake, I'm going to. Yeah, surf out. That's right. All right, cool. Can't believe he still only has two of those in there. God, I gotta go to the bathroom so bad. It's a propaganda first. I'm sitting on islands. Terrible. Actually, I'm gonna go during his turn. I'm gonna F6, and hopefully he just goes out. Let's see. Come on, make it your turn. Then I can F6, and it maybe just lose a few seconds on mine. Oh, I'll just do it now. Okay. Oh, shoot. I thought I got lucky. All right. We'll discard this. Make him worried. Ha. Hopefully I'm still in frame. Here we go. F6 down. How much time did I lose? Not too bad. Oh, boy. Was that worth it? Talk about high tide. Jeez-o. Let's see. I will sacrifice. Is he attacking with everything? All right. I'll sacrifice this and this. We'll block here. And let's just pay for some shenanigans. We're just trying to buy time here. Make him think about stuff. I feel rejuvenated. I can focus. My eyes aren't swimming. In frame. All right. Discard a card. Sure. Why did I do that? Keep it 2-drop when I don't have any mana. Oh, good times. I love when they do this. It's like, just dude, pass the turn at this point. Only way I've got you is if you just keep showing off like this. It's like, good for you. Two walls and a Denrova. I'm very happy he's doing this. Tick-tock. I think he's burned about 45 seconds and he could have just passed the turn and swung for the win next turn. All right. Oh, shucks. But people have that. It seems to be a male thing. I don't see many female players do that where they really just try to run you over and make you extra dead. It's all right. So, well, that took him 13 minutes. Okay. And there is no Rolling Thunder in this, right? All right. Quicksilver's coming in. I'm not sure. Let's see. Take out two cures. You guys think Gleeful has a shot here? Nerd of the Core is in the house. All right. Sometimes they do have Rolling Thunder. Usually only one. Wang Chung 4. I finally made Miss Propaganda live for the last few weeks. Ah, thanks for chiming in. Yeah, we beat Gond earlier, and I said this deck's bad with Tron because I've kind of negated any sort of graveyard hate for the just all-in factor. But what we've learned so far is that we need to probably have Natural State over Gleeful Sabotage, which I've never been a fan of, even with the ability to have artifacts. But, yeah, I'm just not feeling the love there. What do you guys think? Is it worth bringing in Gleeful Sabotage to slow up their early turn? I don't think so. Of course, that list does run the Signet, so that might be good. I'm just curious. I like the slivers. I like all of pretty much everything here. I'm debating bringing in a Prismatic Strands or not. Yeah, I think you're right near the Core. That's kind of where I'm leaning towards. So let's see. And he's playing a pretty counter-heavy build, which is when I really love end-of-turn Quicksilver because at least it gets you something. So, all right, we're going to hope for the best and just bring this in like this. However, Standard Bearer might be, it might at least call to a, what do you call, capsize. Yeah. Let me, what do you think? I'm thinking losing maybe one or two mutagenic growths for the Standard Bearers, just any spot removal they have. Let's do that. I'm not really seeing much red spot removal. Vines for their guys. 2-2-2. I think we're going to roll like that. Again, it'll just buy them time. The only thing, reason I was considering strands is for the time issue. All right. This is decent. Keep. Normally, I would lead out with some Sliver Love, but I'm going to fix my mana right away and try to drop a Lord because of the control aspect of this matchup. Get our mana right out of the gates. And go from there. Boom, boom, boom. 11 minutes for our opponent. We've only got 14, though. Airing on the other side, though. Hey, look at this. You know what? I actually like... I'm going to drop the sliver and this. Plan's changed. He's gaining life with Murasa. I want to get poison in there as fast as possible. All right. There's that. Lord will still land. Come on, land. All right. I'll take that. Go from here. Out of range of Evankar's Justice. Does that list run Justice? I think the best Tron list out there was the one Jasiri won with about 2 weeks ago. Boy, you talk about skill intensive, though. You've really got to nab that. This is what's been pissing me off with Quicksilver, though. I love the sneakiness of this card, but almost every time I'm playing Control, this card shows up when I want to play it as a sorcery-based speed, so it's frustrating. Ba-boom. Gotta be careful. I almost don't want to win too fast here. I want him to take off some more time off the clock. I know it sounds cocky, but given the board state right now, it feels like we've got this one. I hope he does some sort of hiccup, like moments pieces me for a few turns. Darn it. See, that's what we didn't want. That took less than 30 seconds. Dang it. Hey, all right. Oh, to buy time. So now, if this feed ends up having issues at any time, I'm going to have to really ask you for some tech support help there, Little Fight, because this is a brand new computer, and I don't know what went down last week, but hopefully I fixed it. I went through all the startup crap, and there was this little, if anybody got a new PC out there, you know, they have that little eye tracking software, and it's like, why is that a default? That should be like something you force the computer to want to have in there, but strike first, strike out. Yes. I think you want mutagenic growth over standard bears is nerd at the core. I'll do one and one. I'll meet you halfway there, nerd of the core. I agree. I just don't want to get capsized shut out, or in the case of that, let's just try one and one. Yeah, but it does shut off capsize. But yeah, you're right. At that point, you want to be dead. All right, that's good logic. I'll follow that through. Boop, here we go. Look at that curve, baby. 20 lands, 2 curve. And I have to remember that's the whole reasoning behind why I lost Fairy Macabre and Relics, because it was just like, what am I doing here? I'm trying to gotta kind of go for the throat. Mulligan, yeah, I don't think we have to think about this one much. Yeah, seen better, but we'll keep. Bottom. 11 minutes. I do not like that. Hey, at least he didn't lead off with a Tron land, right? God, now watch. He's got, like, Prohibit, and you're just going to slowly suffer. Don't, come on, play. Oh, good. All right. Don't want to run into Prohibit. I just love this art too much not to play it. Let's go. Can we get some Wing Chuns? Oh, never mind. You guys read it. That's the personnel. Here we go. Okay. Well, some echoing shenanigans may be in order here. Let's see. Probably going to grab. Yep, exclude. But that's better than hitting Tron. This is feeling pretty grim already. Kind of keep him off that expedition map, but if he draws it El Natural, we're kind of screwed. Yep, he's probably got a prison behind it to back up maybe a Prohibit. Eh, boy, I play this game too much. Get a life! Yeah, come on. I'm sure we're walking into it here. Yep. Bonk. Oh, maybe not. I love how sneaky Forbidden Alchemy is. It's like, go looking for cards. Put one in your hand. You don't have to reveal Jack. Wambo. Yeah, and big props to Green Prinny, who we faced the first round, but not because of that, and Mathonical. Boy, they have just been top 8 in machines, those guys. Very impressed. Yeah, this isn't looking good, guys. But hey, I said this was bound to happen. I don't think flanking is going to come too much into play here. Mikey Ruru's in the house. Good to see you. Chat's moving a little too fast for me to keep up on, guys. Give me a few. All right. He has no colors, so I really want to run into a vines here and kill that thing. Of course, he might have a... It is probably best to just get a damn lord out. We have more forests than plains, so I'm going to favor the white one. Just in case we get in a little bit of a crunch. I wish I had the balls to attack there, but... Nice. Come on, mutagenics, where you at? Alright. What's this going to get? It is going to grab... sorry, I'm going to have probably jump screen here. He's grabbing Pulsa Marasa. Alrighty. Pulsa Marasa. Let's go get his mine, probably, huh? Pretty cool. Oh boy, I really like this. But I want to keep Vine's Math open. I'm going to lead with this. Okay. Darn it. We'll see. This is tough. I don't really want to attack here. He kills a lord if he blocks, and then he bounces some crucial thing back. I'm going to just pass here. I know it seems weird. I'd rather him get a mine with that Marasa than anything else. All right, absolutely no more caffeine after this. Good grief. All right, let's see. We'll get rid of that. 9 minutes is way too much. Come on, poison sliver. This is getting brutal. Like I said, I foresaw this. Did not come out aggressively enough. Helps that he had Tron pretty fast. Yep. Oh man, I hate this, because now it's like, if I run into it, it's got counter magic. I can't really attack here. What a bummer. 9 mana. What's he got? Flashing stuff back. Celestians, yeah. That does sound like a derogatory term. Anybody catch the top of the show? I got a little shot of Rivendell. I was trying to think of a picturesque place that kind of says Celestia the best, and or however you say that. Everybody knows I'm not the best at pronunciation of a lot of these MTG lore words, but see, I'm just thrilled. It's been supposed to be cloudy all weekend, raining, storming, so I'm happy as a lark. Anti-Celestian here. Everybody's asking these timing questions. There must be a daylight savings time issue going down. All right. I'll let this through. Need that double backup of vines. Let's go. Alright. Yeah, I'll do this. Maybe I can go grab another. Good counter target. Alright, we got a predatory. We got a sentinel. And we got a spinneret. Predatory seems like the obvious call. Come on in for 4. We'll drop that. Any order, baby. Maybe eat a counter here. I'm sure he's got a handful of those and moments pieces and such. At least here, if he doesn't have a counter, we at least can eat a wall, maybe. All right. Tick-tock, tick-tock. course, we don't have much time if he's going to keep swinging for six. It's all this New York talk, guys. Let's keep it magic. Come on, now. Chat amongst yourselves somewhere else if it doesn't have to do with Popper, please. Of course, I don't know what the context is, but I don't care. Ayo. All right, what's he doing here? Going for the Mole Drifter. All right. Gosh, we haven't even hurt this guy yet. Time's pretty much our only way out here. Mike, man, that sounds like my dream, man. All right, sucker. I'm buying time here. Check this move out. Pow! What you gonna do about that? He's probably gonna go get it back. Maybe that's a pretty damn good call, but the spot value of Commune with Nature, Business 42, I think that's... I'm really liking that as a two-drop. In theory, you know, you look at a list like this, and you're like, I'm gonna run all four of those, and... It's like, well, it kind of gets into a clogged hand situation. Maybe three. Still not sold on Orm's Cure. I think, you know, it's one of those new card smell things, even though it's not new. I was like, oh, I forgot about this. You know, one of my favorite searches is Rather Than. And I was like, well, this does run a few more planes because of the curve. That's what I got interrupted earlier by myself, sorry. Meaning to tell you guys, when Mathonical and I were going over the land of this, take away the mutagenics, it's pretty even, but you have to slide it towards planes because of the one drop factor outside of the virulent sliver. There's a few more, twice as many in white. So that's that. And Shiraz and Little Fight stuff gets unpopperesque in the chat. Don't wait for me, man. Just shut it down because we're here to have fun, and games are all about escapism, whether you think that's a good thing or not. Boink! That's what it is, baby. Well, I was so thankful back when all the political crap of the United States was going on a few months, or almost a year ago. It was like, oh, it was so nice to just take a breath and get rid of that crap. Like, let's play the game we all love. Here we go. All right. Down to 6 minutes. We're feeling it now. Ugh. I gotta keep that surprise value. Maybe I can kill that thing. Moment's peace in the house. I kinda wanna keep this in hand just so I can do something with it. I haven't even hit this guy yet. Mikey Ruby, we beat Green Prinny on Gond. Close one, but I forecast this one losing this one pretty regularly. Let's see. I think the best play here is probably to just pass the turn, play a little D, hope that he just goes crazy on tapping lands and staring at him. I'm not sure. All right, so there's eight coming at us. I'll block here. We're probably going to eat a big old fat counter that. I'm sure this is nil. Yep, here comes the counter. Dead meat, sucker. Hopefully he takes 10 minutes clicking and looking at his effects on the stack, marveling at them, getting a little dizzy with the goods. This stage, it's always good to kind of keep your land in hand so you can discard the crap, but I'm sure he's got a flicker right behind that. Yep. Hopefully it takes him 10 minutes, but I doubt it will. I would have sure lost a bet if somebody told me that Denrovia Horror was playable about a few months ago, and then I saw it working, and it's like, yikes! That moment's peace really adds that fuel. Let's get rid of that. Yeah, if you got any messages or links you want to send, just hit up our co-pilots of Shirazamon or Little Fight, and... it's just to keep any non-magic stuff from proliferating. Ugh. Look at this, damn it. Yep, Yeah. Well, we're only at 10 life here, guys. I'm going to scoop. There's nothing that can save us here. Boop. So we're 1-1. Lost to Tron, which I said this deck's not that good against it. So return to details. And I'll be back right after this, guys. And check out this tournament. It's pretty cool.
It were there that I lost me dear Silhanna. She walked her last ledge, but folks, me loss is your gain. So it's in her memory, Silhanna's Window Walkers was created. The finest window scrubbing in all of Ravnica. Cleaning where only flyers dare to soar.
Be reminding them they won't be getting blocked by new high prices with us, John John.
Don't be getting blocked by high prices, Silhanna's Window Walkers.
Guild Pack member since 1906.
We've harvested the hottest spices in all of Dominaria. We've delved deep into the forgotten caves of Kel'Thor to bring you the hottest sauce of any plane. Introducing Flame Tongue Hot Sauce. Our thermal alchemists have flame slashed and fire blasted only the most searing ingredient to bring a flame to your tongue that causes serious damage. Get tongued. Get Flame Tongue Hot Sauce. Deal 4 damage to any meal.
Available at all fine Singer Superstores.
And we're back. All right. I mulliganed. That's all you missed. We will put this on top. And go from here. Yeehaw. All right. Affinity it is, it looks like. Let's lead with this. Go from here. There's the beast. We'll get our beast going. Kapow. This one you really do like Aurum's Cure against Galvanic Blast and such. Of course, we know the three cards in his hand are probably Galvanic Blast. Mike, man. Bringing it in spades, baby. All right. Let's see. Yeah, we're going to let that through. We'll drop that. Okay. That's cool. That's cool. Have to get into a little bit of a holding pattern here. One card. What's he got? All right. That's cool. Drop this. This for this. And we'll pass. Sliver, says Dr. Odd. Thanks for joining us and for chiming in even more. Woohoo! Alright, let's see what this guy's got. Hopefully we can eat a Galvanic Blast here. Better than four. Let me go like this. You think I had a... we know he's got Blast. Let's see. Let's save this one first, in case he thinks we've only got the one. We're going to take 7 anyway, so... No tricks? All right. Well, maybe he doesn't have Galvanic Blast for the first time in history of an Affinity player. Yay! Sometimes stuff works. Right on time. Yeah, sure. We can just use Aurum's Curse here. Or Cure. Careful with that word. So we're going to very carefully play this card if you are new to it. Choose a creature or player. This one. Tap an untapped creature. This one. Prevent 4. Okay. I guess we got to just pay mana for it. Feels better to do it the Tricknology way, though, right? What do we got? What do we got? Come on, I want to just see a lone Galvanic Blast of Hope. Still not out of the woods. refill in his hand. Hey, good. We didn't see an Atog. Okay. All right. Let's drop this. Some big boys here. Slivers can survive. That's why I was playing a little loosey-goosey with mutagenic growth there. Yeah, we take quite a bit of damage, but outside of a lot of thought cast draws, you can kind of trade with them here. And you can see now with a Vines in response to something, we're going to have pretty good game. Not liking that. Four cards in hand. This is not feeling good. Mwahaha, secret text, says Mike Mann. Let's hope. Come on, Galvanic Blast. We all know you're in there. Or two. Stop at that one, please. Stop at that one. All right. I like how he doesn't have any red access. This is kind of cool. Like this. I'll just attack here for the win. So we can double do the chant here. I'm gonna tap two of these to play this with Kicker on the thing we don't really care that much about. And then I'll play this to prevent that. And go from there. All right. We beat Affinity. So they're getting a little nervous there with that double thought cast. It was like pop, 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 pop. It's like, whoa. All right. Orm's Cure is very good against them. Vines, not so much. Gonna lose that for two hollows. Which is like a plus 8 life for most of their stuff. And then COP Red's kind of cool, but I really prefer the Strands. Gleeful's obviously going to be good, bringing these three. Don't have many flyers. It's tough to take out Spinnerets because they're the kind of the meaty guys. You play them and then a Lord's behind them. Before you know it, they're trading with 4/4s. But I'm going to lose them all. So we lost the Vines. We've got two hollow. Sentinels, decent. I kind of want more insurance against, oh crap, it's an Atog. So it'd be nice to get another Prismatic Strands in there. Actually, over a flanker, I'll bring in one more. So I'm liking this. Yeah, hollow is a pretty cool card if you're new to it. When people get a little outrageous with fling mechanics or Tamir Battle Rage. It says, prevent all damage target spell would deal this turn. Gain life equal to the damage prevented. And apologies, I'm going to use the restroom because I got a minute. So I'll be right back. Plenty of time. All right, let's see. Anything looking good or bad since I left? We've got Prismatic. So we've got anti-red Tricknology. We've got some surprise value in Orm's Cure. We got 30 seconds left. Sidewinder Sliver. I'd rather have a Sentinel over that. Let's go from here. Boop. Yeah, flanking might be good. You know, it might be better to lose the poison aspect. Who knows? I certainly don't. Now when I've been having all these 4/1s, I've been very diligent about not keeping one lander, so I'm going to mull. But I might have to keep this. Oh, boy. What do you guys think? M. Curry 16. Hello. Thanks for chiming in. Come on, Peanut Gallery. Do we keep this? Ooh. He's keeping his, I think. Mole. Yeah, I was just saying we mole, but that's, boy, mulling a 5. We've got double hate cards here. I My spidey senses say keep. We're up one game. What do we need to... I mean... I'm gonna keep it. We'll keep it. We'll throw this on the bottom. And we got one more chance. Come on, green. Definite mole first turn if I don't see it, but still got one more shot. Don't make me look like a fool. Come on. Roll. Little drum roll. Sorry if that sounds like crap. It's on my mic stand. Double furnace. What's going down? I always kind of giggle when people bring in electricity against slivers. It's like, really? It's like letting me play a free duress. Not a good start. Oh, God. How to auto-lose in Popper. Just go ask Deluxikov. Always watch the replays, says M. Curry. Then the stream is here. It's nighttime. All right. I'm glad you could join us. I always like when we get new blood and they chime in, especially. A lot of times, Little Fight will send me a list after the show of who's there, and I'm like, hey, we didn't even hear from X, Y, and Z. And I guess people are just shy. Well, we got something. Maybe if we discard, we'll have a little prismatic. Wouldn't it be funny if we grab Hollow and the guy goes all out and just tries to screw himself, goes all in with the Tog trick, and then we gain like 48 life, and it's like, good luck. And then we start drawing our lands and come all the way back. That's the dream anyway. 20 lands, a third of our deck, and here we are. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. He's almost already got us. Or does he? Yeah, I was trying to find a Celestian. Am I saying that right? Colored shirt. I don't have many greens left. They're all in my winter closet. I haven't got that out yet. First storm coming in. Storm. It's ridiculous. It's sprinkling here and there every other day, but LA people call it a storm, and I've lived here too long. I've gotten used to it. I've become a flatlander officially. Yeah, he's going to teach me foot and mouth disease. God, I wish we had a little crystal ball known if I would have mulled again, but with the double gleeful and prismatic backup, I just thought we might be able to shut it out there, but not the case. Perfect 18. Beautiful. Wambo. I got to try playing that deck one of these days. All right. I don't know about Gleeful Sabotage. Feels like we're the aggressor there. It does take out their dudes. We'll keep it. Like that, like that. You know what? I'm thinking of losing these because Prismatic Strands is better. And it's pretty unlikely we're going to be able to poison them. So I'm going to lose all the slivers. This is a new thing for me. I'm going to bring in the two Sidewinders. The other one. And a pulse? No. We'll just bring in one of these. Boop. Go like that. Cap up. Here we go, boys. This is game three. Trying to go up 2-1 here. We'll see if we can... Ah, so far I've been okay against Affinity. Nothing slam dunk. This feels pretty good. I think we'll fix our mana early. We'll keep this. Hopefully the guy goes all in with Hollow and he isn't... what's it called when you watch somebody on Twitch that you're actually playing? That what's that term called? I know it's a negative thing, but kind of spying on them or whatever. But hopefully they're not doing that. Cop up. Cap up. Who's ignoring you? Ghost, says Mikey Ruru. Mikey, it's good to see you again. It's been a while. I've been off Discord. Not on purpose. I just... every time I'm on Discord, nothing against the app. I just... like an hour or two goes away from my life, and I'm like, all I did was chat with an echo chamber. So usually I'll go there like when we're doing a new commercial, and I want kind of that hive mind of, hey, you know, what card does this? Because everybody's really eager to tell you what they know, and it saves you a bit of search in that way. But all right, we'll go from here, play this, get our mana right. Play nice and slow. Go. So, do we gleeful right out of the gates on his tree? Or we try to get extra value out of it? We'll play Sidewinder. Save it for the creatures, probably, unless we see him really getting screwed here. Okay. Oh, this might be a good time to do it, guys. Oh, man. What's the call here, guys? What do you think? You know, play a Lord and attack? Do we... That's it, Maximum. Thank you for that, and thanks for chiming in. Do it, do it. What do we do here, guys? We can't cast it with Conspire. Tempted to blow up that land. That's probably the better play here. What, we play the Lord and... Stone Rain, says Green Prinny. Get more value. Lord into Seam Solid. Blow up the lands. Crack the art land. All right, you guys... Seems like the majority of you want to blow up the land. We'll do it. And we'll play Lords next turn. Ugh. I'm going to roast it. Well, at least it's better than a Lord. What I want is another plane, damn it. Alrighty. This is rough. 2, 4, 3, I'll get to that. I'm going to drop the Lord. We'll swing. Make it on his turn. Belcher Mage. Hey, glad I made the show. We are too, buddy. Kenwaku in the house. Maximum 2945. All right. Don't really care outside of the Prismatic Strands flashback. I'm just trying to make him use his resources on his turn. God, I want a plane because I just want to drop another Lord and have that hollow backup for either Galvanic Blast to gain us 8 life, or he just goes obscene with the Atog. It's so fun. It's only happened, I think, live on Twitch once where somebody just went alpha with an Atog and it was like, hollow. I'll gain 36 life, and you scoop. Here comes... Oh, I thought this, well, that was a Galvanic Blast. See, now I feel like a jackass for clawing that up. Could have at least nabbed an Enforcer with it. Oh, well. Yeah, that's right. All right. Yes! Oh, that feels so good. And we will wait. I believe we'll block the Enforcer. Definitely have more creatures than he does, so I'm not too worried about that. But now, do we worry about the galvanic move, or do we try to just... Hopefully he strikes with the Atog like that. Oh, Belcher Mage, that's you. That's great. I didn't know. I can't put names to faces online a lot of times. So, yeah, I played it as our first commercial break, so we'll keep doing it up until the day of the tournament and... Hope for the best. I hope you guys have a line around the block. Be cool to, that's a hell of a prize. Anybody joining us late, they have I think it's in Illinois, a $1,000 store credit prize tournament. Maybe I'll run it at the end of the show too, in case nobody has to rewind it if you're watching on YouTube or came in halfway. Ooh, okay. Well, that's interesting. Flanking is going to be a thing. Oh, man, I love Prismatic Strands, but I want it to be in my yard right now. Flanking. We'll drop this. Most of our surprises are in our hands, so... Now, what do we want to play actually next turn? Yeah, we'll grab the muscle. Give me some muscle, baby. I gotta play a little tight here. This is the game. I attack with that. I think we just attack with the this dude, right? Anybody else dies. Gotta lose stuff on his turn here. Yeah, I'll try to do that little fight. Gotta love flanking. Look at that. Kapow. What's he got? Oh, another Perilous Research. That's the card I was telling you about, little fight. You got that in your Simic creation? That was that deck that you were putting black in. I think that it might have been better to just keep it blue for that card, but who knows? Feeling pretty good. We dropped that other Lord all of a sudden. We've got Vigilance, we've got Flanking, and the only thing that can really hurt us is a gigantic Kaboom spell, and we've got the mana for it. I would just really like a Prismatic Strands in our yard. Thus the avatar that I'm inside of here. If there was a deluxe sliver, I would like this ability. Cause to be able to discard would be really cool in slivers. Hollow Blowout, yeah, that would make this a very sweet act like, oh, shoot. Tamir Battle Rage for everything. There's another one. Man, he's almost got 10 cards on us by now. He's got to have Fling. Well, that makes me feel really good because Prismatic Strands is going to feel really good after that. Maybe I don't even play the Lord here. Lord Almighty. Ooh, things are getting spicy. Let's do it, suck up. Sure, something's going to eat up Galvanic Blast here. I think that was a misplay. I really should have just attacked, sat back on Strands. Everything has Vigilance. Still had the Hollow backup and then played the dude next turn. Blast will gain us 8 life if we want to go that route, but I don't think I want to. I've seen Affinity come back from spots like this too many times. I give it a wide berth. And Vigilance is actually meaning a bit of a difference here. What does he have? Let's see. It's better than hitting our face with this Galvanic Blast Breath Mint that's coming our way. Alrighty. So what do you guys say? Should we save it? We would gain 8 life. He's probably got Fling or maybe even Battle Rage behind that. I don't think it's worth it. Okay. I love when you're playing a two-color deck. There's something so simple and clean about just having two basics of each one out. It's like, doop-doop. It's nice when it works. Don't save. Yeah, I think so too, Maximum. Got to remember them. Tired of playing auto-lose Rogue the last few weeks. I mean, this is somewhat Rogue, but it has a chance at least. Look at my lords. Look at the beautiful lords. What's he got? What's he got? Is he going to drop the Lord? All right. Boy, I think that was such a big misplay on my part. Really should have... He's going to take... Why is he doing this? Oh, because of the flanking. That's right. Good for him. Gosh, I'm playing the card and I didn't even see it. All right. Maybe we'll get it. Thalia 224, hello. Thank you for chiming in. Everybody's in the house today. Let's see. All right, we'll take that. I can always prismatic here. Still have the ability to crash it back. Boink. 5-5, huh? Maybe not. Yikes! Prismatic is not good against big fat robots. Yeah, God, that was a huge misplay. I should have really run in Strands back up, because then it would be in the yard and I'd have a free spell. Arch Naomi, that's right. Oh, thank you for that, Shiraz. I appreciate it. I was about to forget that. This play is really 50-50 with Affinity. It's just Lords versus Robots. But he didn't screw up. Come on, have a color, Murnforcer. Where's the love? Big ol' 5-5. Damn, it's big. Come on, where's our Gleeful Sabotage now, right? That'd be nice. That'll work for a little bit. Yeah, I think we got a double block with the Sentinel and Sidewinder pretty soon here. We're getting a little too low on life. All right, come on now. 7-6-6. All right, well, there is that. Certainly. Let's stop losing life. All right. One card in his hand. Is it a Galvanic Blast? The way he's blocking it might be. All right. How is everyone? I know I don't show up very often anymore, so I wanted to check in. Thank you for that. It is great to see you. Okay, everybody's doing all right. 6-6. Oh, what is that? Is that a fling? Do I do this now? I can't. That feels good. We like seeing that. Got to do the despondent wait around. Gosh, what a defensive hand we've got. Double Strands, Hollow, Horum's Cure. Ah, trick, trick, trick. Force before planes. Okay, so he's going to be able to kill four of this. We will block, and I don't like this artwork more, so I'm going to go like that. So he can do six. Three is going to go to that. What do we do here, guys? If we prevent the four there, not quite sure how that works. 3-6 will go over. Let's try this. I will target this, and I will tap this to prevent four of it. What has he got? Is it that? Well, that kind of blows. Well, regardless, he still loses something. Okay. Our guys both die. But now, it's the Atog show. Oh boy, this would be sweet if he really goes all out. I almost don't want to play this sliver. I want to act like we just didn't draw anything. Ooh. 13 minutes. This is cool stuff. This long pause might help our cause. We're not going to attack in. I don't want to show that we've got Strands. Just want to play the despondent loser role here. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, what do you think we do? I want to be able to have that flashback, though, too. What do you guys say? I don't want to play sneaky. I'm just going to sit back and not do nothing. Now, he's running Dispel, so I wonder if he's only got one card in hand here. Right. We can get it in there at least. A lot of times they'll try to, when this is on the stack, that's when they'll fling, and that's kind of what we're hoping for here. Nope. All right, so he doesn't have Dispel and he doesn't have Fling. Or that's about all we can do. Well, we've got some defense now. Drop this again. Monsieur Galvanic Blasto. Does he have another? Or is this when he flings? I'll say red. This works out nicely. Can attack here and not have to worry. Red has been prevented. Eight it is. Okay. This is when we want the fling. We can only flash it strands back once. Do we let the seven hit us? We'll get him with red. Halfway through his cards, they kind of have to have it here, don't they? So that'll die. This might play into our plan here if he goes all out. Yeah, all right. Okay, we'll let that die. Now we might be able to bait switch him. Red. Three blasts down. He's probably holding the fourth, as we all know. I'm trying to, Business 42, I'm trying, whether it's right or wrong, to really bait out that last card. Oh, come on, where's our lords? I'll take your advice on this one, maybe just let it hit me, because there is only one Galvanic Blast left. Three to the dome. We're at seven. Not the card I wanted to see. We can't really do anything here. Rough. Can double block and prevent red if he doesn't go alpha here. It's not looking good. I would like to have his side of the board more than ours. 28 cards. If he's 10 cards up on us. bad thing with this play here. So now if he galvanic blasts us, our hollow trick is out the door. It's interesting. If we draw another one, we might have it there. Attack with both, be able to zap the one that gets through. So we need one more mutagenic or some sort of trick, but it's a nail biter, ladies and gentlemen. Drawing cards. Come on, where's your fling? Where's your battle rage? Go crazy. He's got a sack one here, right? All right, we're at one. Don't like that. Gosh darn it. Oh, I know all about strands in the yard, but thank you for reminding me. I think I've made but one misplay today, but come on. Get crazy with fling. Of course, he's not going to without strands, but watch me flash it back here, baby. All right. We're going to block here. A flashback strands for the red source. Hopefully he's got an answer. Say red. Where is this fling at? Trying to make this work. At least we kill that dude. Red's already been prevented, so if he does have a galvanic, longest affinity game in a while. Jeez, what's going on here? That's the idea. Gonna have to double block here. Don't have. Oh, I was hoping. I thought he might have perilous research there. I'm like, come on. Definitely this deck's, oh gosh, I think we're going to go down 0-2 here, guys. I don't think there's any, of course, he just saw double prismatic. He might be pretty nervous there, but that carapace really, well, you know, it didn't save anything, and we still didn't have the win there, even if he just drew a land, so we were just drawn dead at that point. All right, the better card here, because we... did we bring in both three strands or just one? I know it seems weird. We'll rock with that. All right, we're extra dead here. Come on, I want to just see a greedy fling. This guy's way too patient of a pilot for your standard stuff. Boop. Well, normally a little fight two-thirds of the way through the deck, the guy's going to have some sort of fling move. And since the Atog showed up early, I've been kind of sitting on it, waiting for it to be kind of that surprise extra kaboom. Sometimes people get so mad at blockers, they just, at this stage, kind of go for it. But yeah, we're gonna die to just straight up Atog here. Oh, maybe not. We have one more turn. Yeah, we're dead. We are going to take about a 4 or 5 minute break after this. I'm going to have some standard stuff to roll to. And let's see how... There's always that chance that they just say, tired of you blocking and doing this stuff. I'm going to fling. course, not with two cards in hand. But that's a good observation. Maybe Hollow is a bit too much telegraphed, at least at the late stages of this game. There's just no reason for him to go for it, and there's no reason for me to pull the trigger. I can't, because he hasn't cast a spell for it yet. I'll rock here. And plop! First time ever. I knew it was going to happen. 4-1, 4-1, 4-1, 4-1, 5-0, and when I go live, it's this. But anyway, I'm going to go use the facilities. I recommend you get up, move your legs, and we'll be back right after this.
Welcome to Sideboards Explore. Here are the cards you should always look to first when building a proper pauper sideboard. First on our list is Coral Knight. Being able to eliminate the worst threat on the board for one mana makes this card shine, especially for a color that lacks good removal. Crypt Incursion's ability to eat aggro players' graveyards and gain horrific amounts of life are not to be overlooked. Crypt Rat's capability to kill everything on the board is awesome. Make sure to master the multiple activation tricks to get rid of pesky undying critters in one swoop. Curfew punishes players for going all in on a creature. It's especially good versus Kiln Fiend decks and Hexproof. Curse of Chains can be used as removal in any white or blue decks. Great for isolating threats like Gurmag Angler. Duress goes a long way towards ruining your opponent's game plans on the very first turn. At worst, you get free intel on your opponent's hand strength. Electricity is one of the best mass removal spells in the game. For years, commoners were forced to brew with cards like Seismic Shudder to combat small armies. Not anymore. Flaring Pain is the only answer outside of a counterspell for some of the most powerful fog effects Pauper has in its arsenal. Ghastly Demise is one of the most efficient removal spells in all of Magic, so long as your opponent isn't of the Swamp persuasion. Gleeful Sabotage is a flexible card versus artifacts and enchantments, allowing a 2-for-1 removal effect for a small amount of tempo loss. It's a great starting point for dealing with artifacts and enchantments. Gorilla Shaman is hate at its finest. This card obliterates affinity decks. However, never cast this without backup mana. Gutshot is simply amazing. You're able to eliminate the majority of early Pauper threats. This is the card you should be playing with in almost every deck you brew. Hydroblast and Pyroblast are fantastic catch-all options for decks that run enemy colors. Lumethred Field is nasty tech for decks that aim to go wide by playing a lot of little creatures. The majority of mass removal comes in black and red, and aside from early discard, once this sticks, it's impossible for black or red mages to remove it. Martyr of Ashes is often forgotten in red decks and sideboards. While it often doesn't activate for more than 2 or 3 damage, if designed around, this card can be an absolute backbreaker. Moment's Peace often feels like multiple time walk effects on the battlefield. Do not underestimate the power of fog. Okiba Gang Shinobi. This is the card your opponent never wants to see. If left unanswered, it can turn the tide of battle if not dealt with immediately. Prismatic Strands. If you have access to white mana, you should be running this. It can often act as a one-sided Wrath of God. Obviously good versus big red spells like Rolling Thunder or Fling, its ability to flash back makes the power of this card border on being absurd. Rancid Earth's dual nature with regards to its threshold bonus makes your sideboard feel like it has access to 19 cards. Clearly a wonderful card versus Tron and other mana-hungry decks, it's also a great board sweeper for small creatures. Relic of Pergentius is a necessary evil in many sideboards and metagames. Remember, you can trip this while your own graveyard recursion spells are on the stack. For example, Raven's Crime, buying you a card and saving your own graveyard synergy. Serrated Arrows is especially mean with effects that can return it like Core Skyfishers. This card can really put the brakes on opposing tactics, usually gaining you a 3-for-1 advantage. Shrivel is one of the most feared cards in Pauper. Because it actually doesn't do damage, it's almost impossible to prevent. Be careful when you cast this, however. It's usually best before attacking, as it affects your creatures too. Snuff Out exemplifies sneaky removal and shines versus Kiln Fiend-style decks. It's wonderful for stopping recursion loop combos even when tapped out. Standard Bearer can be gruesome versus decks like Stompy, Elves, Hexproof, etc. The play mistakes and game tempo this card causes are legendary. Stormbound Geist is a superb option for blue mages in both the mirror as well as heavy removal deck matchups. Silvok Lifestaff is a bastion of hope against damage, brilliant in creature combat. Be careful when playing this as it can really make games go long. Remember to watch your clock. Veridan Longbow is magnificent for the same reasons Gutshot is, only with the longbow, you get to keep doing it. Finally, Wretch Mind is the closest thing Pauper has to the staggering power of Hymn to Turok. So much so that many of our designs, when warranted, include artifact lands just in case we run into this.
Like Popper? Then you'll love Color Commentary, the weekly Popper podcast for all Popaganda Nights. New episodes every Sunday.
Are you feeling bogged down or despondent? Has a friend or loved one noticed you look withered? Then Phyresius may be right for you. Phyresius is an all-natural Phyrexian supplement that can give you a different outlook on life. Do not take Phyresius while enchanted, equipped, or half-shroud. Players taking Phyresius should not man vehicles for at least 3 turns. Avoid contact with humans or merfolk if you've had a recent gut shot or have had any interactions with a graveyard. In extreme cases, exile may occur. Ask your alchemist if Phyresius is right for you.
Available at Maross's Market.
And we're back. Had to mulligan, had a one land hand, but now we run into a little few too many lands. You, do we pay our dues, or, well, I mean, we're going to keep this four lander. Question here is to, we'll keep. We'll see what we're on here. Kinwaku, color commentary, yes. Yeah, yeah, thanks for all the props there. I still don't think if Hymnoturok was legal, I'm sure you'd have that surge of mono black trying to come back in the fray, but we'll throw this on the top. Should we? Boosts are always good. I'll top it. And I think we'd have that initial like month play where, you know, just because of sheer volume, people would be getting in with it. But I think in the end, it might actually end up not seeing that much play. Outside, I mean, if mono black's well positioned, of course it's going to see play, but I don't think it's strong enough to make mono black a thing. That's how I meant to say that. All right, we're going up against probably some sort of control variant. We'll get the slivers online early. Maybe drop a sanctuary next turn, at least be able to eat an edict with this. Yeah, well, that's what we experimented with last week. Kinwaku was the black cat. Of course, it was a Halloween show and kind of had to go a little tongue-in-cheek with it there, superstition and all, but it's a lot of fun. Sure didn't win much. Alrighty, well, let's just pay the dues now. Bring this out. Not too worried about about edict effects. Only got one. This is not the kind of start you want against control. All right. Well, that's better than an island. What's this? Hey, he's a little bit desperate. This is good news. We can at least stultify the board a little bit. It's nice having 12 lords. The lords and ladies. Okay. Drop this, and then the one we don't like the artwork for. I shouldn't say we. Maybe you guys do. This is just so much more surrealistic. I've always thought this was Rebecca Guay's art, but it isn't. And maybe they've got some sort of life technology. Who knows? 2-3, we're out of range. A lot of damage spells are black-blue, except for Agony Warp. We will see. Been playing UB Storm. Mikey Ruse has been playing UB for sure, since it's good, even if you can't cast it on 2. Ruzmov. In the house. All right. Caffeine's wearing off. Sorry, I got a little sleepy there. No excuses. Ha. All right, what do we got? Hopefully he's just on an Evan Carr's justice build and he's pissed off that all of our stuff has a Jennifer Lopez-style backside, sized backside, I should say. We've got 2 and 2. Let me drop this now. Bladed Slower or the Sinew. Well, we are the aggressor here, so let's do that. Any order will be good. We'll keep this up. Attack! Whoa! Gonna lose the chant in this one. These games can get a little ridiculous. There's sometimes I'll play like this against Tron. I'm not saying we're gonna win this one. I mean, end of turn removal, followed by another one, and all of a sudden we're kind of in the dumps. But yeah, the second I made the decision and not really focus too much on the graveyard and just kind of go for the throat, I was doing pretty good against Tron. I think I was actually 3-0 up until last game. But like I said, my stat sheets are divided amongst about 20 different pieces of paper, so I've got to kind of consolidate that if I look to play this even more. But I knew in the back of my brain, I'm like, all these 4-1s and then that 5-0 I hit with this list, I'm like, today it's not going to do that. Let's just be real. Hey, how cool does that look? This figure, it's like, that's not doing nothing against all these wannabe affinity dudes. This is when I love it. I know I've been over this before, but when you're going against control and they just, the onus is on them. They have to do something. They cannot sit back and just wait to kill or counter stuff. It's probably a Gurmag. Yeah, coming out. Boink. Ooh, desperate Gurmag. Look at that. Fine by me. Love this. 2, 4, 6. I believe that's the better spell to get countered is this sliver here. So we'll play it first. Play this. Never works when you really want it, says Into the River. Yeah, they're probably stuck on either countering or trying to stay alive via one removal spell, but got them on the ropes pretty good here. 4, 6. I got a swing here. I mean, even an echoing trick doesn't really work here. Our lords are all different. We'll see. Him would be fun to try, but I think it's too powerful for Popper. I don't think so, Ken Walker. That's kind of my argument. I think if Mono Black's a thing, it's going to be a great card, but it is only 4 of. And how often are people almost hellbent in this format anyway? I'm not saying it's not powerful. I love the card. I'd run it too, but I just don't think it'd be the backbreaker everybody thinks it would be. It'd be just like Fling is. It's like, God darn it, that thing usually gets me, but it doesn't always. All right. What's he going to kill? We know he's got some trick up his sleeve. What's going down here? The poison damage does him in here, even if he's got some sort of trick. Killing that dude. Taking 8. Well, that sucks. I always like when people do that. Yeah, if I ritual, and then do X, Y, and Z perfectly, it wins. It's broken. Believe me, I've tried that many a times. It happens about 1 in 598 games. And when it does, it's against somebody that you'd beat anyway. It's never this perfect, cool thing. Yeah, I've almost thought of bringing in the Monarchs and the sideboard against control builds so you can just kind of have a steady stream of slivers. I'm not sure if I even like Gleeful style effects in this deck. I'm so habitually just against graveyards and wanting to have issues, but that's a pause of I'm 1 mana away from pulling this off. Just going to Alpha Strike here. We'll drop this. I'll feign like I've got vines, but I'll wait. Come on, give me an easy win, please. What sort of treachery is this? All right, he's going to grab something. Put one of them into your hand, and you don't have to show me what anything is. That sucks. Poison's going to get you. If left, doesn't. Don't know of a way out of this. Tendrils, he doesn't have tendrils, Matthews. All right. Well, hey. This is Demir. I just call it that. I'm an old timer, sorry. Okay, so a lot of stuff's going to be dying, so Moross is probably good. Orm's Cure is useless here, unless he has the nut draw. We're screwed, and Evankar's Justice shows up, but if that's happening, we've lost anyway. So Quicksilver I like a lot here. Nice to have that little end of turn stuff. We'll keep this. We saw some mold drifters. Vines is good. Mutagenic's good early on. I think that's all we do. Unless anybody wants to say anything, I got plenty of time. Yeah, we've had plenty of desperation digs ourselves in the last few weeks. Everybody have a good Halloween? I sure did. Actually, I didn't. The actual Halloween night, I mean, I did go to that party the week before, but the actual Halloween night, I had to work like crazy, and it was just one of these nights where the powers that be would look at something and just change it to, for the sake of changing it. And creatively, it's frustrating. Like, you make a song or you make a trailer and you see it get dumbed down by cooks in the kitchen. Not to say that my first cut's always the best, but I try to make it that way. And it's frustrating to just see it slowly get worse the more people input on it. It's opposite of like magic decks. That's what I really like about magic decks. People go, hey, have you tried this? Have you tried that? And things work out. So, yes, sir, everybody. Okay, well, I guess we're just going to go here. We've got 32 creatures, and everything else goes and gets one or saves them. So let's just see what happens. In a little fight, too, when we chat later or tonight or whatever, maybe do a little bit of know-how on what causes the fan on this computer to go crazy. Because every once in a while, like when I move things around, you'll hear it go like it's really trying to cool off. Not now, but maybe if you can answer that for me later. I obviously mulligan this, yes. All right, we'll keep. I'm going to throw that on the bottom, actually. Well, this is tough. I want more critters. Watch, he has a disfigure, and then it's just off to the races. I'm going to throw this on the bottom. I want more creatures. Got our sliver. And it's so fun playing a creature-filled strategy that doesn't just auto-fall to electricity. All right. Our man is right. If he wants to do this, that's cool. We'll just sliver him to death. Stock cooler fan. Well, that's the thing, MKRI 16, is that this is a brand new computer. It's like a month old. So I'm just wondering if there's some workload I'm throwing at it that I shouldn't be, that sort of thing. Do we walk into a counterspell here, guys? This is when it feels clunky when you don't. You've got both mana, but sometimes the math doesn't work out even when you have the equations behind it. Yeah, he's got removal. I'm just wondering if he has a counter spell. We still hit him if he has that. Bait it with a poison sliver. Yeah, we can't really bait anything, though. If he counters it, then we're just... I think we save the Lord for next turn. It's like, you want to use your Doomblade or counter spells on these little guys? Go for it. I'll play Patient, which is a rare thing for me. Yeah, I'm thinking and I'll do a little psychological warfare here. And because you know that's a bluff when you're playing against Slivers. It's like you always want to cast your stuff first. Opponent's at 1850. We're at 20. We're good on time. Poison starting to stack up. I just love Virulent Slivers when they start stacking up. So many people miss that each sliver does two or three. It gets pretty crazy. Oh, is that true? Yeah, so I just am completely oblivious to what happened last week. It just, if you watched last week's the end of the show, it just completely like froze up. And I was like, all right, I guess we're just dead here. Given that he's probably only got one mana. We got double Lord next turn. Let's try to get rid of a counter. He's probably got exclude hanging out. I can double lord next turn, and I like being able to. This is really starting to put the brakes on him quick with the double poison. He might not realize this, and then he's going to go, oh, crap. It's for a turn. Next turn, he's dead. Better kill something that is kind of lame. He's probably sitting on a Doomblade or worse, waiting for the opportunity to, ooh, or not, to strike. Because, I mean, he's got, that's 2, 4, 6. He's dead next turn if I don't do anything, so that's what's neat. Of course, he might have just found his justice and we're screwed. But even so, let's see, hard justice. I don't think the odds are good that he packs Shrivel against Slivers with 12 lords and, well, 16 cards that boosts stuff. So I'm going to get rid of the Predatory, I think, here, guys. Unless I hear otherwise. They do have Echoing. There's that to consider, right? Don't double lord. What do you guys think here? I mean, I think the obvious play is the Sliver, but if he's got Echoing Decay, it's... Yikes. Burpman 263, thank you for chiming in, my friend. Yeah, we'll get rid of that. If he's got that, he'll have to do it now. Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Well, that's feeling good. Now we've got an answer for Echoing Decay, right? At this point, you almost want to drop the Predatory Sliver. Let's hope. Let's not. I've been cursing myself plenty with writing W's that slowly turn into losses. Well, that sucks. That tells us a lot about his hand, doesn't it? Guys think I should double lord here? That's the question. Double lord? Can I get a double lord? Double lord puts us out of range of a lot. Double lord. Can I get a yes to a double lord? I think so too. What's boring, Lacquerding? What's got you down, my friend? Sorry, the chat's always a little bit behind. Sometimes I'm just loving this weather. I can actually wear something long sleeve and not be sweating while playing. Good times, good times. All right, well, Yggdrasil, it's been a while. Good to see ya. Very nice of you to stop by. Alrighty. I don't have the damage, but I think he's going to try to kill the Sliver. That's a pretty safe bet. He's going to try to block the Sliver. I hate when I have vines at this stage, because if I do it in response and then he still has the removal... You guys think I should have kicked the vast wood on the Virulent? What do you say? it's worth it. What's he got? Here comes the hate. All right. Now Orm's curse or cure would feel pretty good, right? Got plenty of that. We'll go get this. That dies. All of a sudden, he's got life. Of course, we could always drop another virulent, right? Did we bring in Marasa? I can't quite remember if we went for just the aggro plan or what. Not too worried about a chittering rats in this build. All right, what's he going to bring up? Let's see. Wait, did he just show that? Devour Flesh. Okay, I didn't know if that was from before or not. Well, that sucks. Okay. Tapped out. Who knows? Maybe he'll forget. Always wishful. Well, if our deck just draws what it should, he does have an edict, but he's 2 mana from that. That's pretty good. 4 turn clock here if we don't draw much of any answers. He's 2 cards in hand. I think he knows we're on a forest here. That's fun. But we still can't get in. Boy, it represents a little bit of a creepy threat. Now we know what's up. I'm just going to play that. I don't think he's falling for it. Alright. 1 card in hand. 2, 4, 5 mana. What's he got? Nothing in the yard except the edict, but that's 2 mana away. Ooh, I like this aggression. Look at this. He must have removal. Seven. M1 Gurna, good to see you. Bounce back, what, the backwater? Yeah, you'd think so. This is true, Lacerdine. Yeah, not much evasion indeed, other than just sheer brutality of here comes another 6-6 when it works. That's why I go back and forth between that and Armadillo Cloak, which is a... All right. Well, at least we have a blocker against that. Looks like it's off to game 3. I don't see much way around this, especially if he's got some spot removal right now. Yeah, I ran into a Sliver deck about, 8 or 9 months ago. And it looked clunky as hell, but it used the Gem Palm Sliver and as like a Bird of Paradise. And then it used the Flying, and oh my goodness. I mean, it had like a nut hand both games. But it got me thinking. I expect it did so well that I was like, oh, I'm going to see this in the listings really soon. And it's like, nope. All right. Dead meat here. Off to game 3. Okay. That one had done too much good. That's okay. Not so much. I think we keep everything the way it's at. Go from here. Yeah, Shadow would be cool. So anybody in the chat going to that big tournament out in... I keep forgetting where that's at. Michigan, I think? $1,000 payout. Store credit. Pretty awesome. Very awesome. What am I saying? Pretty awesome. Jeez, whoever heard of that? It's not the first time they've done it either. don't know what's going on there. It's pretty cool. I think three-color sliver might be better, but the mana ain't easy to balance. True, but we're already playing Ash Barons, and one spot thing might actually be kind of cool. Who knows? And, you know, I've already got a little fluff room. I'm still not sold on vines in this list. I really like mutagenic, but if you took out vines and the Aurum's Curates, that's four spots. And a lot of people, what I was running into when I was playing Armadillo Cloak is it, you know, it was either a win more or it was just answered in the way that, you know, you don't, you got that 3-3 trying to make it a 5-5 to really shut the door and boom, they've got the removal spell. And it didn't gain enough life against burn. And so I was just looking for more of a combat trick that was free. And that's why main deck, to make room for sideboards, game two and three, I really like this free spell. Because it can either target you, it's an anti-fire blast, galvanic blast, to anything. So far we haven't seen it in play too much, so. You know, who knows, maybe it's just better to play another spinneret and a sentinel. But so far, like I said, whether we win, lose, or draw today, you know, my son's life, I've had, five 4-1s, I think, and one 5-0 with this, and that's it. There hasn't been a bunch of little 3-2s that I'm not mentioning or anything like that. It's just that's the overall with it. So it's been making me a lot of boosters or whatever you call them, those prize packs. But boy, those things, I went to go sell a bunch the other day, and they went down in like half. So I don't know how much longer I can keep doing this if they don't start upping the prize purse or whatnot, because, you know, collection, especially when you play rogue, it's slowly going down. Yes, I would like to play first. All right, this is the kind of hand we want. Damn it, keep this. Let's we'll lead off with the poison. Screw it. Michigan is across the ocean, says Lacardine. Might as well be a dirt ocean for me. That's about the same distance for me too, but on land. All right, come on now. I'm in the Bay Area every once in a while there. SRS Business 42. Wow, triple virulent. Okay, let's hope there's no disfigures. Maybe he took those out. Come on, tap land. Nope. We are going to go for it here. Okay, that feels good. We'll drop flankings so that Augur of Bolas won't be an issue, and we'll drop this. We've got our anti-disfigure tricks. This might be over real quick, guys. Triple virulent is a pretty nice draw. No disfigure bodes well, or does it? Double poison. This is going to make Infect jealous if this works out. My oldest used to love slivers. He played one online tournament back in, like, I think 2006 with me, and he crashed and burned hard, but that was back when Infect had Invigorate, and it was empty the Warren's decks left and right. Very fun time, but it's a very kid-friendly deck. I'm just a big kid at heart, so that's probably why I like it too. All right, we will lose that. Off we go. Come on, something good. Well, at this stage, I'm going to prefer to keep the poison on board. Because here comes a whole bunch. Crunch. Dead next turn. Neat game, even though it's a control matchup. He's got to do something this turn. Does he got it? Woohoo! All right. So, let's see. We're 2-2, playing for, we'll play this last one here. And hope for the best. So, yeah, we beat Gond and Dimir. We've lost to Affinity and Tron. The Affinity matchup, that's just a coin toss. And I'd say Stompy and Hexproof are actually kind of favorable, at least with my build, with Prismatic in the side. But I think there's about a 10%, not to pat myself on the back too hard, but there's about a 10% buffer against me because I've played those decks so many times that I kind of usually know what their game plan is and such. So Brivenex, oh no, control player from hell. We will keep. He's usually on Delver, so this is a pretty good hand against Delver. We've got a curve out. We've got reach creatures, but he's a tournament regular, and I think he placed either in the top three or something in one of the first big challenges. So, from what I remember. Oh, Mike Man, good luck. Thank you. We'll see you later, buddy. Ha. Lots of friends in the house today. Thanks for joining us, everybody. Good to see y'all, if only digitally. Come on, Rivenex. I've got a show to do here, buddy. I'd love for you to do this against a Tron deck, but I want to keep it interesting. Insert sound effects of snoring here. My headphones are on a little too hot. Boom, boom, boom. Come on now. I hope he's not sniping us, logging in right now. Who knows? Yeah, that was brutal. I've often tried to think of a way to incorporate the Virulent Slivers into just Infect. I sure wish it worked that way. I'm sure there's a few games that would mean that little extra damage, but you might as well play Pistis Strike. Sorry about this, guys. I'm running into a boring wall of 2 minutes of staring at the same screen. I should just roll to a commercial to keep you guys entertained, but the second I do that, I'm sure they're going to bounce right back. All right, here we go. Whoop. We are on the play. We will drop this. I'm pretty sure he's on some sort of Delver build. But yeah, he's one of the top control players, I think. Yeah, I would think like Tribe or Delver Fiend are probably two of the decks you just don't want to see when you're piloting Slivers, at least with this build. Maybe if I ran Vines, it would be a little bit better, but this is good times. Drop this. Feeling pretty good so far. Oh, getting probed. Let's go, let's go. I kind of want him to pull a ninja here. Encourage the trade of 3 for 1 or for 3 for 2, just because it'll kind of tap him out in theory. But he's not having any of it. Well, that's not going to save much. Neither is that. Drop another one of these. Down comes the Fae. That's okay. Oh, all right, that's not expected. Come on over for 3. Feels like we got this, but it's nerve-wracking playing against good control players. They tend to always be able to pull it off there. I'm just really skittish about running into a Macabre, and if I'm going to do anything, I want him to. I'm kind of glad he countered that. I mean, I already got one out. But so this way. See what he does here. Okay. What's he got? See, just now my computer got real loud, the fan. Drop this. Pull back this. Drop this. Probably get countered. Alright, well, at least it's not fairies. He's at 8. We got a lot of tricks. Flanking is so good against so many decks. Just love it. Augur's not a problem with the sliver out. Preordained shows up. It's going to cast it now. Let's see. No, he gushes. Even better for him. Bottom, top. Delver. See how quickly this feels like I can just start slipping away? It's like, yikes, what's going on here? Be nice to get our little vigilance guy going here, right? Or a lord. All right, let's commune. At least grab something here. Virulent, virulent, sliver. Yeah, I think we'll grab the sentinel here. Any order. Of course, it'd be so nice to have vines back up. Darn it. Oh, well. I'll pull this. Boop. Always a good spell. Hey, I expect a lot, baby. Days in the house. All right. Those will be two ones. Just to not shuffle. That's scary. Snapping stuff. Damn it. Terrible. And they've always got a shot, don't they? I mean, that was a pretty good hand against Delver. And look at this. But maybe he has a... All right. Boom, boom, boom. Yeah, blue is pretty badass. Let's see. Do I just sliver here? We're dead next turn if we don't... we play this. Down comes the Fae. Okay. Go from here. Come on, let one of them through. Doubt it. Yep. He's gonna get us. Look at this. Beautiful. Yep, he's got us. I'm not even gonna... Boop. Bravo. The problem when you play a different deck every week is that you run into experts, and even with a good draw, it's gonna be pretty hard to beat them. I'm actually going to bring in two sabotages here. Can somebody look up his list? I think he runs Curse of Chains or something like a Coral Neck. Can we look that up, somebody, please? I would appreciate it. I don't think Orm's Cure is going to be much help here. I'm going to use the restroom. I'll be right back. Can somebody look that up? I'd appreciate it. All right, his list doesn't have Coral Net or Curse of Chains. Okay, well, cool. Now, do you think it's worth it bringing in Standard Bearers to draw off some of that bounce? I don't think so. I think what we have is fine. Yeah. Pulse of Marasa, end of turn. I'm just going to try to be the problem here. Bummer. I won't lie, I thought we had that one, but like I said, always a little nerve-wracking playing against somebody. Mazel used to be that way of, if you used to play Delver about 3 years ago, he was one of the top pilots. And I always, unless I was on a deck for like 3 or 4 weeks straight, it was always like, oh, you always feel like you're just up against it because all the person does is hone in on that one deck, which is great. I need to start doing that on especially on Sundays. I was doing that with Tribe for a little bit and I, you know, I had some pretty good results, but then I, you know, I just get that deck wanderlust. But hey, that's what makes Propaganda good. Just not me, a good tourney player sometimes. I get a little too curious. It's like, hey, what about this? I'm going to try it. Ah, heck, the way he's playing, maybe we'll get him on time. Man, yeah, we had the flanking. We had... Let's try to write down evasion. The takeaways here. I'm just kind of trying to put little footnotes. I have these in my own little notes, but it's nice to get the hive mind feedback. Bring this out. Interesting. What's this for? Like a. Hoping for a quick turn ninja, maybe? No, he runs Daze. You know what? I don't want a Lord. I really want that flanking to get in, believe it or not. I'm going to cast the thing I don't really care about here. Drop this dude. See if it's worth either a daze or a hard counter. Deep Hours aggro deck. You mean Delver? That's what he's on. Okay, now we're just drawn to a land. This would be kind of cool. We could maybe double Lord here. Counterbait. Yeah, 2 days. Yeah, I know. Okay. Gonna mix up our guys here. Go from here. When he attaches a flare husk and tries to trade, we at least have a answer in mutagenic, but he might have the bounce there. Never know. Really? I'll try to save it. Just because I want him to do it on his turn. Okay. Mr. Bullis, you have no effect. Normally a 1-3 is just so nasty because they're able to just sit there and be that roadblock, but Slivers has a nice... I hate this draw. One more land and we're kind of set. You know, it's like I really want to sneak that spinneret in there. But we need to be the aggressor here, and in case he's playing Echoing, I'm going to play around a daze since we know he's got that and go from here. Make him think we're on Vines of Vastwood, maybe? I don't know. In his face! Lackerding. Like your style, my friend. All right, here's that. You're not going to like our next draw. Of course, he could just have Vapor Snag, right? Drop this. Play this. Bring this back. Okay. Well, at least we're 1-1 against a really good control player. And here's for all the marbles to go 3-2, hopefully. Worst outing ever for this deck, but pretty good considering it's Slivers against a top player here. I don't know if we do much of anything different. We've seen a lot of artifacts, and we've also seen Spire Golem. So, obvious question, you think Gleeful's worth it? I don't. Finds that... Yeah, I think we just keep it as is, don't you guys? I love this curve. Look how even this all is. It's like the exact number of lands for the with the one drops, with the two drops. It's like, stick to this. All right, guys, here we go. Fingers crossed. Experience is not on our side. Sheer number of games sure is for me, but I've piloted Slivers. Oh, boy. A total of maybe... I mean, if we draw a forest here, we're good to go, but he's keeping his... We gotta ship this back, don't you think? What do you guys say? I think we ship this back. Outside of drawing a forest, we really only have one play. Don't be shy now. I got 17 minutes to win. Ship it. I think that's what you meant, Lackerding, right? I'm dyslexic. That's what it says to me. Let's see. Yeah. I'm going to mulligan. Not the best hand. Good grief. We'll keep it. Our mana's right. We can at least see our next card. No, I don't want to be flooded against a very good player. This sucks. Not a good start. And it's getting worse. Hey, it got a little better. Maybe he's looking for room for the ninja. Maybe he'll sneak it in there and we'll at least have an answer. Get a mutagenic on top of that. Yeah, baby. Can dream, right? Oh, he doesn't have it. Well... this stage. Okay. Poison you, baby. No ninja, no ninja, no ninja, no ninja. I sure wish poisonous worked like infect when it comes to blocking creatures and making them have wither, but it doesn't. No ninja. Yeah, hey, we're getting a little bit lucky. So I think this might be a neat little bait and hook. If we commune right now, he might counter it thinking we're mana screwed, and we can slip in the spinneret behind it. That's the theory. He doesn't fall for it. Ooh, that's kind of cool, huh? Maybe we can just kill him with this stuff, right? I mean, that's all we can really grab. Any order. Sure. Really want that spinneret to hit. No. No vapor snag. All right. Good. All right. Tempo of the turns on our side. Come on. Let's just get something that is big. That boosts. That lets us at least keep hitting with these slivers. Not good. I can't tell you how bad I am against Bone Splitter Delver builds. I just don't know why people don't run those a lot. You know what? In case he has Daze, this is a lot better spell to cast first. Alright. But yeah, for some reason, when I lose to Delver lists, which usually most of my brews, I wouldn't consider slivers anything. I mean, what, you change four or five cards and you tweak the mana a little bit, so it's definitely not my thing, or there's some like version. They're all so close. But when I do design stuff, I tend to really like to aim at Delver, but when my homebrews do lose to Delver, it's always ones with bone splitters in them. So he's representing the counter here. You know, if I go all in, he blocks and kills one. Kind of has to take everything, right? You guys think I should attack here? Nah, it's not worth it yet. Snap. Okay, well, at least we have a must counter from him next turn. Maybe that'll encourage a swing ratio, but that's 2, 4, 6. Oh, man, how cool would it be to have our quicksliver right now, whatever you call it, darn it. End of turn, zap! Yep, here comes the ninja. Our whole deck is 2, so he pretty much counters anything he wants. Arg. Just happy to get one game off of Brivenix here. Man, I want a quicksliver right here. That'd be so badass. It's doink, doink. That's what's neat. It makes you end of turn them, and it's not just good against Delver. That's why I kind of prefer it over Scattershot, but... Yeah, this blows. Let's see. Come on, spell stutter. Just keep it like that. If I attack here and he's going to kill one of them, but he would take 4 infect damage. Still not worth it. Oh, this guy's impatient. I won't make him regret it later. Let's see. Yeah, 2 damage isn't worth it, even though, never know, we might be able to Maybe we'll draw into another virulent and we can drop the spinneret for a musk counter and who knows. I mean, we're up against it here. No joke. He knows what's in our hand to boot, so. Sentinel can at least block the ninja and stop the card advantage from going on. Oh, I know. I'm going to try to use it as a bait so that we can kind of sneak stuff through. There's the obvious. He's probably going to bounce this. And yep. It's all right. Still don't get your card. Okay. Well, this turns out neat, huh? Play this. Does he have a counter? Yeah, he does. Play this. Here comes the other sprite. Okay. Hopefully we don't run into a daze here. Play this. Does he got a daze for the game? Nope. He doesn't. Well, but we're kind of dead meat anyway. Maybe I need a fourth spinneret in this. I know Methonical was saying that in this metagame, 3 thinks is the right number, but it might be better to just run 4. Once he got a ninja again. Yep, of course he does. This is just like, it makes a little bit more sense for Delver to have the ninja because they're always drawing cards, but it's like the joke we have with Galvanic Blast. It's like, they got it. Somebody's, is he leaving one up? Does he have a Gush here? Is he just going crazy? Yeah, looks like he's got our number. We couldn't have drawn a Lord there. That would have been nice. Or the flanking guy would have been really nice, right? We are up against it, guys. There's not much we can do here. It doesn't make much sense to attack with everything. Block, 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 block. Could it be that you sometimes come a little bit rough on... Could it be that you sometimes come a little bit rough online? Mr. Duct Tape. What you mean? Slivers have got to hit the first 5 turns. Yeah. I don't know what you mean there, Mr. Duct Tape, but thank you for chiming in. Yeah, even if I swing at the Sentinel. Can at least pretend I have some sort of vines or something. At least he didn't get any counter magic. But down comes a golem, and he's... Yeah, this is when I lose. It looks like it's going to be a 2-3 outing today, guys. But it's been fun. Hey, I'm not going to even call it up yet. I'm going to show you that Infect deck next. The Gruul one. I don't want him to draw a card, but... Five, we're dead next turn. The only way we win, let's see. I just don't think we have a way to win here. Keep him off cards, maybe. We're not blocking much. Nick Drozzle says, that's really unlucky. Well, it happens. Delver not flipped, that's something, right? Yeah, I mean, he's gotten unlucky, too. We're drawing a few too many lands here. I wouldn't say we got unlucky. Deluxe is a rough dude offline. Okay. I guess that's, I'm going to block. We've lost this one anyway. Let's see what we got here. No surprise there. Fairies up. We are... This kind of helps, but we're dead meat. Let's see. Nothing can block. Nothing matters. We're going to take 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Too much. So we might as well attack. Try to kill some of them. You guys are speaking awfully cryptic. I'm not sure what any of you mean, but... Boom, boom. He's got us 3-4. Yeah. Good times. Well, there's the Slivers match, but what we want to change here immediately is the Gleefuls. Not liking those, so I'm going to leave a hole there. And I do like the Arms Cure. I just don't know if there's probably a better card. I've just been looking and looking and looking, but it's just the free nature of that spell. But I wanted to show you real quick. I won't play it just because we're coming up on 3 hours here, but the Infect Gruul list that I've got here. Is this, or is it way down here? Where did I put this beast? There it is. Yeah, that's right. Well, last week we didn't plan to win any matches, and we hit our goal, that's for sure. So this is a list I've just been tinkering around with. Definitely not tournament worthy, but like I said, it's a lot of fun, and I had a few wins with it. No 5-0s and a lot of 3-2s. So what this, and you'll notice just a preponderance of double mana lands here. We've got just a crazy amount. Run all four of these. Main logic being, yes, you have a reckless charge and you can flash that back and you want that, but the games where you can really go crazy is when you can reckless and play Tamira on the same turn. So all of our stuff is just there to build this up. We don't have anything other than mutagenic. This for these, four of these, four vines, four mambas, four Ekreclaw, all four lotus petals. Really like it in this build. Any two mana build with this just feels right at home. And four trees and only one forest. Everything else is just a dual land. And it plays pretty well against control. I really like Soul's Fire because you're able to point this with, like, you got a 6/6, I don't know, Ekreclaw Myrrh with infect sort of thing, and you can kind of fling it at them and it counts as infect damage. And that's why I don't run Gutshot or anything like that. In theory, I'm just trying to keep the board clear. These are for fog effects and such. We've got 3 Pulse Marasa, 4 Moments Peace, and 3 Nature's Claim. But you give a deck time, you look at it, and there's already things I kind of want to change about it. But anyway, guys, that's that. Recent discussion, Seeker of the Way, Downshift, any decks it fits into. Not sure, I'd have to see the card up. Still kind of confused, Mr. Duct Tape, what you mean, and same with you about my rough dude-ness. Take that, I guess, as a compliment. But for now, guys, sorry I wasn't a little bit better outing. At least we've got a, little bit of, almost broke even, but I'll probably be playing Slivers quite a bit this weekend. I'm still not done with the deck. I think it's 3 or 4 cards away. Like I said, we've got an Invasion Note, and we've got the Natural State Note, which is nothing new. We're going to just go from there. I'll let you know the update on Facebook if you want to follow us there, or any questions, comments, concerns at popperganda@gmail.com. We're going to roll to a few commercials, and a first thing we're going to show you is the new tournament, $1,000 payout. So check out this promo, and we'll see you next week on Popperganda. Thanks, everybody.